Hi students, I am Professor Awais Ahmed Husseini, working as Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yadra. In lecture number 1, we discussed the fundamentals about that steam generator or boiler. In that lecture number 2, we will discuss related with that fire tube boilers along with their construction and working. So let us start with that definition of the fire tube boiler. So what is fire tube boiler is? In case of the fire tube boiler, the fire is continuously flowing through the tube and that tubes get surrounded by the water. So it is called as a fire tube boiler. So this is the main specialty of the fire tube boiler. And generally, in most of the cases, the fire tube boiler is mainly used in case of the processes, industries, chemical power plant, some kind of the pharmaceutical industry where the pressure requirement is less as compared with that steam power plant. So this particular fire tube boiler is generally used in low capacity steam generation power plant or some kind of the processing and food related industries. So let us start with the first type of the fire tube boiler is simple vertical boiler. But before that, there are so many parts or terms related with the boiler. You can say it as the components of that boiler, and this component is same throughout in all aspects of that fire tube as well as water tube boiler. So in case of the steam simple vertical boiler, there are a lot of the parts you can see in that image. The first important is that shell. So shell is nothing but it is a metallic. It can be manufactured by a fabrication process by proper welding process. So the material of that shell must be corrosion resistance. The second important is that grate. The grate is situated below the combustion chamber. So it is a platform in which the furnace upon which fuel is burnt. So this is a space where fuel is burnt. So generally here we consider coal as a fuel. So we keep that coal on that grate for burning. Then on bottom side you will get that area of that ash pit. So after combustion, whatever the ash is produced, it get collected at the bottom section of the boiler, and the section above that grate is supposed to be combustion chamber. Means students, you keep in mind that in case of the boiler, the heat transfer takes place because of all three modes. But most important thing is, with the help of radiation, the heat transfer takes place around 70 to 80%, and in between that 10% to 15% because of convection and approximately 5% because of that conduction. So that radiation is the most important in case of the combustion chamber. So this is the area of the combustion chamber through which combustion of the fuel takes place, and that flue gases is continuously move on the top side, and it can be exhausted at the end through the chimney. So this is again very important thing. The chimney is the next part through which whatever the combustible gases is arrived, it can be dissipated through that particular area. Along with it consists of n number of the things related with the mountings. So here you will get idea. Here we use safety valves, again steam stop valves, pressure gauges, manholes. So every mounting have is its own application. So manhole is necessary to clean the furnace area, as well as if some kind of the maintenance occurs, then it will help you. Also, in order to clean the inner portion as well as to clean that chimney, that manhole is necessary. Pressure gauge is required to know the pressure of the steam. Then safety valve is important as far as safety norms of that IBR. Steam stop valve is also necessary in case of the emergency purpose. Also, this simple vertical tube boiler consists of that cross box, and the either side of that cross box is hand hole is provided. The main function of that hand hole is to clean the tubes which is located in the area of that cross box. So in cross box, the tubes are there. Okay. So this is the most important thing in case of that maintenance point of view. So the next important aspects of that simple vertical boiler is accessories. It is not visible in that particular case, but it is a separate point, that mounting and accessories. But students, keep in mind that in case of the steam power plant, the mountings are very essential in order to run that steam power plant smoothly. Without mounting, we never run any kind of the steam power plant. But another term is related with that accessories. So what is the function of the accessories? Yeah, definitely the accessory will improve the performance. If it is not there, then it never affect on the steam generation. But if we use that accessories, then definitely the performance and overall efficiency of the steam power plant will definitely increases. So this is all about simple vertical boiler. So in boiler, the main function of the boiler is to convert that water into steam by evaporation process. So latent heat of evaporation takes place. We must have to give heat input, then and then only it is possible to convert that water to steam. So this is all about simple vertical boiler. Students, the second important fire tube boiler is Scotch marine boiler. The main specialty of that boiler is it is probably the most popular boiler for application in the area of the range 1000 kg per hour and pressure of around 18 to 20 bar. It can be composed, compact in size and occupies very less space as compared with other boiler. So, and the as far as that construction is to be concerned, it is quite easy as compared with the other fire tube boiler. So students, here the components of students, first of all, keep in mind that the component used in all boilers are same, but the only arrangement is different. So here you can see that it consists of the furnace, but here if you see that image in clear, then definitely here you get idea n number of the furnace parts are there. Here three furnaces are used, 1, 2, and 3. So each furnace having its own combustion chamber on their back sides. So here we get idea about that fire hole. Then furnaces, the main specialty of that Scotch marine boiler is it is having a multi furnaces in the range of 3 to 7 as far as that application is to be concerned. But for that medium capacity range, generally 2 to 5 furnaces are used, and each furnace having its own combustion chamber. So here the grate and that furnace is a single unit. So here, so whatever the, if suppose the coal is there and after combustion, whatever the burned gases is travel through that particular tubes, and finally here is the smoke box. Here the smoke is collected and finally it goes out through the chimney. So again, this is a cylindrical type. It is mostly used for medium capacity application where the pressure requirement is in between 70 to 20 bar approximately. And students, keep in mind that in case of that fire tube boiler, the fire is continuously passing through the tubes and the remaining portion it gets surrounded by water. So this is the main working and construction of the Scotch marine boiler. The third important fire tube boiler is horizontal return tubular boiler. So the arrangement of the tube and the boiler shell is horizontal, so name itself is given, horizontal return tubular boiler. So the construction is very easy here. So the furnace, that is combustion chamber, is on left corner where combustion of that fuel is carried out, and tremendous amount of fumes, whatever generated, it continuously passing through the tubes. These are the tubes bundle. Through that continuously flue gases and heated gases are continuously flowing, and finally it goes out to the hot gases through that particular area of the draught, and after treating, it enters in the atmosphere through the chimney, and the rest portion is of that particular shell is covered by water. So definitely the heat transfer takes place here mostly because of conduction as well as convection, similarly by radiation. So here the water get heated because of that convection and conduction, and continuously that water get converted into steam, and finally that steam out from here the top section and it get located in the steam drum. So this is the construction and working of horizontal return tube boiler. Generally this type of boiler is mostly used in food as well as in textile and some kind of the processing and packaging industry, where requirement of the pressure in the range of 5 bar to 7 bar. So as far as construction and maintenance point of view, it is very easy as far as construction as well as related with that, there is a very less kind of the maintenance problem is there, and the total shell of that horizontal boiler is covered by some kind of the insulation material. So here again on the left side furnace is there, and through that furnace the heated gases are flowing through the tubes, and the rest portion is get covered by definitely by water, and finally that because of that heat transfer that water get converted into steam, and steam enters in the steam drum. So this is the construction and working of the horizontal return tubular boiler. So the next type of the fire tube boiler is that Cornish boiler. The main specialty of that Cornish boiler is, as far as that construction is to be considered, it is quite easy. Here you will get idea in case of the side view. So here you can see that the brick material is there, construction is there. Also over that the one cylindrical shell is there, and only central hole is provided. That central hole is nothing but that flue tube. Only single tube is used through that. Whatever the combustion of fuel takes place, that combustible gases are continuously flowing through that tube. So this is the main specialty. Also the product of the combustion pass from the fire grate forward over the brickwork bridge to the end of the furnace tube. Then the return by the two sides of the flue to the front end of the boiler, and again pass to the back end of the flue along the bottom of the boiler to the chimney. So as far as construction point of view, it is very easy and very less maintenance facilities there. So from where the combustible gases is continuously passes, and here they get returned again from the back section, again they get collected. So this is the main specialty of that Cornish boiler. Also, as far as that particular pressure generation capacity is to be concerned, this particular type of the boiler is mostly used for 10 to 15 bar capacity, and the length of the shell is in between 4 to 7 meter, and the diameter of that particular shell is 1.25 to 1.75 meter approximately. So this is a very good boiler as far as that high capacity application is to be concerned. So these are the advantages of the fire tube these are the disadvantages of the fire tube boiler. The basic are, the water is supplied in the shell and outside tubes, while hot gases is supplied inside tubes. So the water volume cannot be shaken easily when the fire tube boiler is running. Similarly, fire tube boiler is so easy to use, operate, clean, maintenance is very easy. Then as far as disadvantages is to be concerned, the efficiency of the heat transfer is bad throughout because of heat exchange is very poor, and due to not because of that thermal radiation. Also, there is a from the furnace combustion.